He says your M-A-F-F is incorrect.
Right? Right. I learned how to spell from the Mill Creek Library.
He also said that he was talking to all nine of us.
Right.
Apparently,
y'all make up for 12.
We make up for 12. So what kind of
M-A-F-F is he?
Oh, bravo. Bravo. Hey, guys. Hey, Facebook. It takes all three of them to do one math problem.
This man's got folk has problems.
You know what? You know what? I'm going to say this one more time. I'm going to beat the stink out of you tonight at Tiger Valley High School. So you...
Whoa. Where's my belt that you're going to lose tonight?
Very funny.
I brought what I'm putting up for the fight. Where's what you're putting up?
First of all, let's get it straight. My belt is not worthy of being here today. You know why?
So
my belt
worthy?
Is not worthy of being here today. I don't want his 3,000 crummy fan hands to touch my tire. So I will put it on the line tonight when I want to. How I want to, but I will walk away from this podunk town state
with two titles.
Oh, and by the way, my title got ladies on it. It's got hearts on it. I mean, don't get me wrong, he got a great belt. It's cool too. But mine's 14 karat gold, diamond encrusted. That's right. I went to the hood and I stole it from this guy's house. Yeah. Yes, the Army of Eight.
If you could just give me 2 seconds. I do have a question.
What?
Your belt's not worthy of being here, or we're not worthy of being in the presence of your belt?
Get it right now.
You know what?
How about this? After tonight, no hard feelings, I'll sit you down, and I'll help you rewrite this entire promo, and you can refilm it all up.
Oh! No!
Because not only is your M-A-F-F absolutely incorrect, your English is horrible, your diction is even worse, and your attire is absolutely hideous.
This guy says my diction is even worse. Let me tell you something about my diction, buddy. It hasn't stopped the ladies from coming around.
That's a terrible pun. That is a terrible pun.
You know that was good. Let me tell you something. I'm the one-take wonder. I am the master of the promo. I am every man's role model. I'm every woman's supermodel. I'm great and you're not. I'm the woman loving.
He's every man's role model, but he's not mine.
Because you're not a man. Now back to what I was saying. I'm the woman loving, girl hugging, lady rubbing, smooth drinking, erotic thinking, womanizing, realizing it can't nobody do it better. That's a real promo, courtesy of a Screen Actor Guild, chump.
So all that practice stuff
hey,
was great.
She showed up for my autograph. Hey.
Oh, hey. By all means.
She showed up for my autograph. I was good with doing it. Hey, listen, see this guy right here? See him? All he do is go around America, trying to charm people, trying to be a great guy, and telling everybody how great he is. But tonight, if you show up in the high school, don't cheer for him, okay? He's back. Really? She said she showed up in kindergarten. Guess what? You and that guy got something in common. Because he's still in kindergarten, too. He takes a nap every day. He sets his thumb.
You want to come on in and meet some real wrestlers, honey?
Oh.
We'll be more than happy to come talk to you and you can hang out with us.
You're a kid, I'll tell you what you can do. You can go over there. He's in kindergarten, though. Yeah, he's in kindergarten.
Yeah, me too.
He's got the IQ of 2-year-old, but he's in kindergarten.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sometimes I got shared.
Oh, yeah?
She's
doing a way better job.
You know what? These guys are saying that you cut a better promo than me and you're a better talker than me. You know what? That really hurts my feelings that you guys would insult me like that in front of an innocent child. How dare you? Where's your moral compass? Let me have that. See this? Fans just throw money to me. Unlike these guys, these homeless trailer park trash guys. Look at this.
little girl gave me 25 cents. And just 25 cents, you can support a starving wrestler like that loser and that loser. Oh, this guy ain't starving, I'm going to tell you right now. Look, what you been eating, man? Dead bodies?
I like
I know it's Halloween. No, 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 look, I'm going to tell you right now. I'm going to wrestle you. I'm going to pick you up. You're too massive or too strong. I'll take care of you. Your knee, your ankle, I'll take something out. Well, this guy right here, it's really easy for him. You know what you do for this guy? Go to a chicken joint. Call the cops and say you robbed him.
I think you get some of that right there.
That's a big chicken. You want to see a bigger chicken?
You don't believe me.
See that one coming.
Hey guys, let me show you how nice I am. I actually give to my fans. I love my fans. Watch me give the little girl a quarter. I'm gonna give her a quarter.
Give quarter.
I'm a very
thankful
fan. Oh, you see that? See, I give away stuff. Unlike you, phony Storm. Now I know all the kids love you. I know you're always the fan favorite wherever you go. I know that people just go gaga over you. Well, guess what? You don't fool me. I've seen him come and I've seen him go. And tonight, bad wind coming. Bad wind blew it away. Yes, bye-bye. You will fizzle out like Florence, Harvey, Katrina, Rita, Camille, Betsy. You will fizzle out like all your dates and all those mammoth storms.
Yeah. When I fizzle away and take your championship with me, don't cry, don't be mad, don't be upset. You can come follow me wherever I am throughout the United States. And you know what? I'll let you challenge me for it again.
You know what? You just made me mad. So I'm going to do you a favor.
Yeah.
While I go and call my agent to try to get you all fired. Why don't you go over there and we'll give you an autograph. He'll give you an autograph and get you. Yeah, I gotta call my agent. Where's my cell phone? It's called Gathering of Owls. Check it out on Amazon. I'm gonna say it again. Carlos Hotness was in a graphic novel called Gathering of Owls. Amazon. You guys was nowhere. Where was you at? I forgot. These guys aren't famous. They're on a t-shirt they got from a discount store.
Bro, you want a free shirt?
Here you go. Take this free. I'm going to give away their merchandise for them. Take this and she can cut it up for her Barbie doll. Hey, put this on your Barbie doll. You can have that courtesy of me. See, I give to my fans. Take it. It's yours. Yes, you can have it. I'll autograph it for you.
Be a heel, man.
Give me that. Thank you. I'm autographing. Hey, y'all. I'm going to autograph this shirt that I made for these losers, and I'm gonna give it to one of my fans. Watch this. Ow!
Doesn't that sound so much better?
It do, don't it? See, I proved the point. They say that villains are the worst. No, we're not. Good guys are mean. He wouldn't even give the shirt to that little girl. Pan-American heartthrob champion. Every woman loves me. You get it straight.
Where's your championship?
I will not bring my belt so these degenerates can get their filthy chicken-eating greasy hands on it.
Belt's not
especially working. This black standard guy. Anyway, check this out, buddy. You got a date with Destiny tonight. You can't fulfill it. Your fans can't help you fulfill it. I've knocked out more guys. I've blinded more guys. I've been up around the world wrestling. When you was out being a little boy, I was traveling the world beating down grown men. All right? So just because you got these nice little guns and your cute little jerry curl, that don't make you a grown man, and it doesn't make you better than me.
Carlos, my resume runs deeper than the words that you keep spewing out of your mouth.
Wait a minute. Hold that.
You want to call?
No. Hold that. No. Slide over, right? Hey, slide over. Because I want the world to see a bully in action. This guy!
You talk living legend. There's nothing more legendary than being honored by the Cauliflower Alley Club, the only 501c3 charity organization for professional wrestlers by professional wrestlers. You want to talk about legendary status? You're looking at it. You're standing in front of it. You want to talk about your resume? Let's talk about the last 6 months of my career. Matches against Billy Gunn, Chris Masters, Gangrel,
Carlos Hotness.
Yeah. And after tonight, Carlos Hotness. And I'm going to go ahead and mention that all four of these gentlemen, Robbie E, have all fallen to the hands of Tony Storm. But hey, at the end of the night, you are going to be amongst that elite class, and you can put that on your resume.
Yeah. You know what? This guy tells me he's wrestled all the greats, and they've fallen by his crocodile hands. He got little hands. Anyway, they all going to fall. You know what? Buddy, this is fall, and you're going to fall in the proper season. Because it is Halloween time, and I'm going to bury you. They say we got a guillotine match tonight. Well, guess what? Your job and your neck is on the chopping block, along with your pretty little curl. Speaking of which, this guy talks about he's a member of the prestigious Garden Cauliflower Wrestling Club. Oh, bravo, he's a master gardener. Bravo, bravo. You know what? I want to show you this. Look at this. Look at this. You see that? You see that, ladies? He ain't that great. I'm more handsome. I'm more brilliant. I'm more better looking. I'm more charismatic. I'm richer, taller, smarter, stronger, and I'm better than this guy. Sure, he looks like whatever. Maybe some decent.
A billion bucks.
You know what? If I am eye candy, this guy right here.
Guys, you don't have to hang on the door. Y'all just come in. Just let him do his thing. We'd rather talk to y'all.
Oh, no, come no, on no. Just leave him alone. Come on in. Matter of fact, no, dude, come on in. Come on in.
This guy's
when I beat him down, I want as many witnesses when you call the cops. Now, come on in. Get comfortable. Have a seat. Meet Casa. Sue Casa. These guys are so rude. They're not going to invite you in. Come on. Come on.
I'm good.
Yeah, you're good. You're good. Okay, great. Because I'm better. And I'm better than him!
Well, tonight,
those little things,
Carlos,
I'm better than everybody!
Carlos,
this guy, he's not gonna come and step on my credibility! Here, you know what?
I'm adding to your credibility.
Guess what? My cat needs toilet paper. Thanks for the photo, buddy. Ain't that right, Mr. Boo? I love you too, my little Moxie.
Hey.
Can't do that.
That's right. You know why? Every great hero needs a mascot. And every great guy needs a sidekick for all the great villains. I had to drive myself here. There's no Uber here. This town is country. These folks ain't even got Tinder. They got Tinderloins. They don't even have, like, Tweet. They got Tweetbird. They don't have YouTube. They got y'all too. I can throw an ice cube down the street and freeze everybody out of this town because it's so small. But tonight, it doesn't matter. I got one small problem, and it's this guy they say blew me. Phony Storm is my small problem. Let's get this right.
How small of a problem do I look?
How small of a problem do I look? Well, I would say 3 inches. Yep, 3 inches off. So let's get this straight right now, pal. I'm Carlos Hines. I'm better than you. I will always be better than you. And there's nothing you and your movie home perm can do about it. Yes, I just disrespected you in front of your 3 subscribers on, well, this town is country. They got Facebook. How you doing? How you doing? So anyway, I just disrespected you right here in front of millions of Carlos Hotness fans. So let's get it straight. Phony Storm, if you think you're a real man, why don't you put your belt on the line right now, right here in this comic shop?
I have a contract that states I can't touch you until we get to the high school tonight. And if I break that contract, I don't get paid. If I don't get paid, we've got a problem. Beating you is going to be great, but doing it in the right time and the right place in front of these people and everybody else who comes to the high school tonight, it's going to be just that much sweeter. And taking your phony championship that doesn't clearly exist. It's gonna be amazing. We're gonna keep this beautiful thing around my waist. And then maybe I'll use your title as a coaster.
He's gonna use my title as a coaster. That's a good one. I bet you stayed up all night trying to write that, didn't you?
No, right now what I'm trying to do is knock your block off.
Knock my block off. I told you he was a kindergartner. He plays with building blocks, people. Let's get this straight right now. You can't touch me, but I can touch you. It ain't in my contract, Jack, and I do read my paperwork. And speaking of paperwork, title versus title, I got a surprise in my contract specifically for you. So we'll see how it goes down in that ring in Mill Creek, Tiger Valley High School, West Virginia. Tonight, baby, you and me, me and you. And guess what? I'm gonna send you back to Gatorland, Florida. Coast, you're going back to the Gulf Coast. So you can go back to training school, boy. Now, I gotta go. I haven't eaten. They break bone called my limo, and I shouldn't be here right now. So, phony, with much obligingness.
That's not a word.
Obligingness is a word.
No.
Yes, it is.
Okay.
No, obligingness, like much obliged. Obligingness is a word. Don't correct me. Yes, it is. Obligingness is a word.
Change it twice.
I didn't change it twice.
Anyway, it's going wrong twice. With all due respect, is what you were looking for?
No.
And we can. Yep. With all due respect, you're gonna go because you have to go eat. There's a Hardee's down the road. We get it. You're done now. Is there anything
down the road
that I missed?
We get it. And we're done now. Is there anything that I missed? You know what? You're gonna miss a lot if you come into the ring with me. And do me a favor, Phony Storm. There's a flea market up the street. Go buy yourself some new clothes, chump. Holler, Army Losers.